Definitely. You know, I think I got a lot of support wherever I go, just because, you know, just my whole demeanor is just how I am. You know, people can walk up to me, you know, I'm reachable, untouchable, and things like that. They look at me and see themselves in me. So, you know, I think I have a lot of support. I have a lot of fans out there, you know, and I think, you know, they're going to support me because, you know, I don't only fight, you know, to get the victory. I fight because I want to be crowd pleased. I want, you know, the crowd to entertain itself too. So, you know, I think I have a lot of support comes out of
that. Talk about that demeanor and how that helps you in situations like this, the big fights that you're into, that calm demeanor. And then also, on the flip side of that, when you turn that on for the fight to be a monster in the ring?
I think the demeanor helped me a lot because a lot of people they don't really know if I'm excited or not.
That's very true.
Yeah,
very true.
They don't know if I'm excited or not, or, you know, just a regular day. You know, that's how I'm looking. So, you know, that's just how I am. And I think it helps me a lot because it keeps me calm and it keeps me focused. And even come fight night, I'm not wasting a lot of energy, nervous, and, you know, batting my fingers and moving around. You know, I keep a lot of it stored inside of me until the bell rings, and then I unleash it all out. So,
how do you keep calm before the big fight like this? What are you doing to kind of relax yourself and just kind of, I know you got your family with you got your girls to kind of keep you smiling. She was actually trying to steal the show out there when you were doing your dance. But how do you keep calm?
It's just how it was then. You know, I can't just say I practice it, or, you know, I'm even meditating or something like that. It's just something that's always been inside of me, somewhere I've always been, even as a little kid. You know, I always had that calm demeanor, so, you know, it's just me.
Talking about Man Down Promotions, talk about that, where that started from, and then Strap Season, kind of how the collaboration and all that, and the initiation.
Well, I started Man Down Promotions. I actually have three fighters on this card. So, you know, they'll be fighting on the card. They're all undefeated except one. He has one loss, so, you know, it's going to be a great event. And they're all from Dallas, too, so, you know, I want to keep it at home first and then bring these guys up, guys like Burley Books and Amon Rashidi. So, you know, I just want to keep it at home and keep a small stable. I don't want a huge big stable because you can't focus on everybody with a big stable. So these guys I have, only three, I can just build them up and get them on cards, and hopefully they'll fight for a world title and put them in the best opportunity.
After the fights, you always call out everybody out that doubted you before the fight in the press. We know you pay close attention. Is anything said in the press or by anybody that pissed you off a little bit that you can't wait to answer?
I always pay attention. You have to find out post-press conference.
You said that you're going to try to go for Manny Pacquiao after this, and if not, Terrence Crawford. Is that kind of the two main guys you're looking at next? One or the other?
I mean, it's a lot of guys on that list. Like I said, I can move up 54, or, you know, I can stay. You got Danny Garcia, you know, you got Pacquiao, you got Crawford, you got a couple more guys, Ugas. So, I mean, I got options, so I'm not worried about if I don't get the Pacquiao fight, if I don't get Terrence Crawford fight. You know, there's other quality fights up there for me, so I'm not worried about it.